Tadeva ramam ruchiram navam navam tadeva sasyatamanuso mahasyavam tadeva sokarnava sosanam ninam yaduttama sroko yaso anugiyati tadeva ramyam ruchiram navam navam tadeva sasyatamanuso mahasyavam tadeva sokarnava sosanam ninam yaduttama sroko yaso anugiyati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is the only slogan of Gauriya Math. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is the slogan of Gauriya Math. Srila Saraswati Thakur told, Prabhupada told, that it is the duty of all Rupanuga Guru Varga to do Sankirtam, non-stop Sankirtam, all the time. It is the only procedure adopted by a Rupanuga Guru Varga. How you can detect that he is Rupanuga, how to detect? Prabhupada speaking, Prabhupada told, if you find all the time they are doing Naam Sankirtan, Srinam Sankirtan, then be sure they are actually Rupanuga Guru. I can give example from Bhagavata and different Garga Sangeeta, different place, you can see. Those who are Gauriya devotees. Gauriya devotees mean those who have connection with Radharani, those who throw everything onto lotus feet of Radharani, same thing. You can find that those Gopikas or Bhajavasis, they are always chanting about Krishna, glories of Krishna. When Akrur came, when Uddhav came, they could see the same situation, they are crying and doing Sankirtan all day. This is the procedure, the only procedure. So you can detect that he is Rupanuga, he is not Rupanuga, you can detect. And also yesterday I was discussing about this point, that how to understand that he is doing solitary bhajan. How to understand? I told, Prabhupada speaking, Kirtana Prabhave Smarana Haive Sekale Bhajan Nijan Sambhav. I was explaining this point. When through Sankirtan, continuous Sankirtan, under the guidance of all Rupanuga Guru Varga, if you find that there is no material thinking there, no asasanga, no trace of evil association coming to contaminate your thinking, heart, in that case, be sure you are doing Nijan Bhajan. Among all thousands of Gauriya devotees, you are doing Nijan Bhajan. Prabhupada also used to see. Now you can put question before me, Maharaj. We heard that Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj was doing exclusive bhajan, nirjan bhajan, Jagannath Das Babaji, we have seen their solitary bhajan. But we see Prabhupada is just doing opposite. Apparently you can see that Prabhupada doing just opposite of what Gurudev used to do. But actually it is not like that. Apparently you can find that Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj is doing solitary bhajan. But if you have power, bhajan power, then you can see that Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj is doing Sankirtan all the time, all Guru Varga with him. Together with Gaur Nitai Panchatattva. All the time, Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj dancing, singing, you cannot see because you are blind. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj also same thing. If somebody used to take permission from Prabhupada, Prabhupada permit, we like to see the lotus feet of Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj. Prabhupada said, no, don't go. If you go there, you cannot understand his activities. You can misunderstand him. Don't go. That's why 2 days ago I was speaking this thing. Try to keep a safe distance with pure Vaishnava. Because you are going to find fault with them. No fault is there, whereas. This way, Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj giving 3 standing instructions to Prabhupada. One is don't go to Kali Brahmanda. One is that don't try to go to Kali Brahmanda. Amar Prabhu, oh my Prabhu, don't go to Kali Brahmanda. You stay with me. It's good. And don't try to make any disciple. This way, you see, and another, don't try to make any disciple, math temple. But apparently we see Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada totally going against Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj. Also, I can refer one example that Narottama Thakur, his Gurudev, is Loknath Gos Goswami. You all know this simple thing. He took decision, resolution, that I am not going to make any disciple. And anyhow, he was bound to accept Narottama Thakur by his seva mood, to say his excellent seva mood. He was bound to accept this disciple. But Loknath Das Goswami doing solitary bhajan, you see, same thing. He is doing Sankirtan whole day and night, Gopinath Das Goswami, and all Saparshat Gaur Hari there, but you cannot see. Now point is that, how is that possible? Narottama Thakur gone thousands of miles away from his Gurudev, going to his village, there Kheturi, and establishing nice mat and deities all, and making thousands of disciples. So apparently, you can see it is against Gurudev. But those who are actual Rupanuga Bhajan, those who are doing, those who are Rupanuga Guru Bharga, they can find it has same, you know, significant. Like I told you, when Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, Purusher Kit Hoite Muisha, Jagai Madai Hoite Muisha Logishto, Purusher Kit Hoite Muisha Papish, speaking this way. When Vrindavan Das Thakur speaking, I am speaking so much, giving evidence, this, that. But still, if you are not ready to accept, then I am going to kick onto your head. Then you can think, apparently it is contradictory. Vrindavan Das Thakur is not Trinadapi, he is Trinadapi. But our Guru Bharga, Rupanuga Guru Bharga, they want to prove this thing, that the same significance is there. Even, I would say, that Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya is showing more and more kipa to all of us. So, our Rupanuga Guru Bharga can prove that is of same significance. You cannot understand. So, this way, Narottama Thakur making thousands of disciples, whereas Loknath Goswami not making any disciple, only one by chance. See, all same significance, because they are all doing the service of Gaur Hari. Sri Chaitanya Manavishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutan. He is doing this way, he is doing this way. All their ultimate goal is to satisfy Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through their bhajan. They are making disciples is also one kind of bhajan. They are making disciples is one kind of bhajan, not for Pratishtha. Don't think that way. Now, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, I am not going against my Gurudev, believe me. I never make any disciple. They are all my Guru Varga. I never make any disciple, believe me. They are all my Guru Varga. They give me, giving me chance every time to do actual bhajan. They are guiding me. They are giving me facility to do bhajan, to do Hari Kirtan. So I am saved. They are my, you know, they are always protecting me. Prabhupada speaking this way. And I am not going to Kali Brahmanda. Believe me, I am not going to Kali Brahmanda. Gauriya Mission, Gauriya Math is not Kali Brahmanda. I am going to Gauriya Math to chant Harinams, to do Harinam Sankirtan, to speak Harikatha. I am totally following Rupanuga Guru Bhargava. I am following my Guru Bhargava, Rupanuga Guru Bhargava in toto. Because I have the chance to speak Harikatha there in Calcutta, Gauriya Mission, Gauriya Math. So believe me, actually, I am not going to Kali Brahmanda, I am going to Vrindavan. Dibyat Vrindaranyakalpadramadha Samadatnaga Singha Sanastho Sisi Radha Silagavinda Dibbo Upeshtali Visab Manu Swarami. This is the quotation given by Rupa Goswami Pad. Exact this seva, this procedure, this situation is there inside, environment is there inside Gauriya Math, but you cannot see, you are blind. Dibbad Vindaran Kalpadramada Satma Samatnaga Singha Sanastau. In Gauriya Math, the same procedure is being followed by our Gauriya Guru Varga. You cannot see. They are doing seva, they are rendering seva of Radha Govindo under the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, under the guidance of Rupa Goswami Pad. But if you have eyes, if you have darshan, as it is. Darshan means what I mean to say, as it is darshan, what is what? That you cannot see. Because some kind of impediments, barrier is there at present, that is called maya barrier. Agyaneno avritam jnanam, teno muhyanti yantabaha. Agyaneno avritam jnanam, teno muhyanti yantabaha. That's why you cannot see properly. As it is, darshan is not at all possible for you right now in this situation. But those Rupanuga Guru Varga, they can see well, that kind of seva is going on inside Gauriya Math. But other people, those are owlish person, they cannot see. They are blind, they say this kind of, you know, excesses going there in Gauriya Math. So much appliance as this, that, what need? They can go and sit in solitary place and do Harinam properly. They are always doing excesses. Baba was a no man. We are following Rupa Goswami Pad in toto. You cannot disprove it. So you see, Prabhupada speaking, I am going to Gauriya Math. Gauriya Math means Vrindavan. If you have the chance to say inside Gauriya Math, if you have the chance to say in, if you have the chance to stay inside Gauriya Math one night, then you are the luckiest person in the world. Can you see? Can you stay in Gauriya Math? Eh? With perfect darshan. Then be sure you are staying in Dibyad Vrindaranyakalpa and Jogopit there. All seva going on, Radha Govindo, divine couple, all, you know, gopikas around them, always serving you. This kind of seva going on. So this is the topmost place in this material world. What is this place? That is Gauriya Math. That is Gauriya Math. Now, actually, never try to make any temple. Never try to make any temple. But Prabhupada speaking, I am not making any temple actually. Actually, I am establishing this Aprakita Mandir. I am, you know, I am bound to make nice places where all devotees can do Nam Sankirtan, non-stop Nam Sankirtan. That is the place, that is Gauriya Math. I am not making any temple. Actually, temple means where, you know, deity is there. But actually, Gauriya Math is not only temple. Gauriya Math means where spiritual aspirant, those who are having their desire to do render service, they can have the chance to stay inside Gauriya Math. They can do Sankirtan, they can serve. So, Mathanti Basanti. It's Gauriya Math, it's not actually temple. Actually, temple means where deities can stay and only serving, but his mouth is more significant, Gauriya Math. Always they are serving. Now, yesterday I told you one thing, that somebody putting question before Prabhupada, Prabhupada, who is, you know, Vaishnava? How I can understand? Who is Vaishnava? Prabhupada told, you see, those who are trying to do some service all the time, those who are trying to do some service for Supreme Lord, I mean Dham, Nam, Parikar, Vaishishta, Paraphernalia, all they are actually devotee, bhakta. They are actually, how I can know they are devotee? If you find they are continuously all the time, they are trying to do seva. But any seva you are doing, it is the instruction of Jiva Goswami Pada, you must do under the guidance of Nam Sankirtan. Jadapi anna seva kalu. Sankirtan and naiva kriyat. With Sankirtan you will have to do non-stop Sankirtan. Our archan is also topmost Sankirtan, Prabhupada proving. Bhagavata first slog janmadasya yato namayaditara asyarta savigya sarado tene brahma hidayo adhikavayam ihanti yat surayo teyo vare midam yatha vinimayo tisargaham misa dhamna seno sada nirasta puhakam satyam param dhimahi. So in first slog it is written satyam param dhimahi. I mean, Vyasadev Goswami inviting the whole world, Jiva. Vyasadev Goswami, it is plural number actually, not singular. You all come. I invite you all, come. We together can do Sankirtan. Vyasadev Goswami. Sankirtan mean? No, it is not written. Satyam Param Dhimahi reading. You are, why you are changing this word? No man, I am not changing. I am speaking the truth. I am changing? No. Satyam Param Dhimahi. Dhimahi means merited. But Prabhupada, topmost Rupanuga Guru Varga, he is going to give evidence. He is going to prove. See man, what do you mean by meditation, dhyayam? Satyam Param Dhimahi. Bayam sarve satyam payam param dhimahi. Bayam sarve. No singular number. If there is singular number, satyam param dhayemo. Not singular number. So Vyasadeva Goswami, also you can find that Prabhupada want to prove the Vyasadeva Goswami, what Vyasadeva Goswami is speaking, same thing, same topmost secret is there with Rupanuga Guru Bhargava. Same thing. Why? Prabhupada speaking, our archan is also Nam Sankirtan. Nam Sankirtan is topmost dhyan. Nam Sankirtan is topmost, you know. Nam Sankirtan is topmost meditation. Yesterday I already put mathematically. I proved. You can remember. Why? I told you Sankirtan, hearing and Smaran, all same, interrelated. If there is no Sankirtan, you have no scope to hear. At the same time, you have no scope to go for Smaran. So it is interrelated. Sovan, Kirtan and Smaran. Oh? So Prabhupada want to prove this thing, that you see, our, in, you know, Kali Yuga, you see, only Sankirtan. Kriti yad dhayato Vishnu, tetayam jayato makhoi, dapore, dapore, are a simple sloka, you cannot remember. Kalu, Kriti yad dhayato Vishnu, tetayam jajato makhoi, dapore paricharjayam kalu utad hari kirtanat. Prabhupada want to prove in four yuga, you can find different mode of bhajan given. But Prabhupada want to prove is all the same. You want to meditate? So topmost meditation is Sankirtan. I already proved. Prabhupada want to prove Krite, Krite means Sattayug. Sattayug, it was the procedure to meditate. But that meditation is 100% perfect when you are doing Sankirtan under the guidance of Guru Bhargava. There is non-stop meditation. Now I am in meditation. I am doing Dhyan. Don't believe? Yes. Now, actually, Tetayam Jajato Makhoi Yajna. So what yajna mean? Prabhupada speaking, Sankirtan yajna is topmost. No other yajna is just parallel to Sankirtan yajna. So Prabhupada want to prove that, yes, in Teta yajna, this mode of bhajan is different, but still I can prove this, that in this Kali Yuga, if I do through Sankirtan, it is topmost yajna. Dapore, Paricharjayam, Paricharjamani, Archanadi, say, where it is topmost Arshan you can do through Sankirtan. And in this special Kali Yuga, all Kali Yuga Sankirtan is there, specially this Kali Yuga, when Krishna manifesting Leela, after that Krishna gone, then Krishna Chaitanya coming, this Kali Yuga is special Kali Yuga. Here, Sankirtan Yajna is topmost. And all Kali Yuga. That doesn't mean, Prabhupada speaking, that Kriti Jodhayato Vishnu Tetayam Jayato Mukhoi. Kriti Jodhayato Vishnu Tetayam Jayato Mukhoi. And this doesn't mean, Prabhupada want to speak, that this doesn't mean Kriti Jodhayato Vishnu Tetayam Jayato Mukhoi. And dapore tat paricharjayam kalo utad hari kirtanat. Prabhupada want to prove this thing, that don't think that in other yuga there is individual procedure there. You don't think that in Satya Yuga if I do Sankirtan I cannot come out successful. What Prabhupada want to say? Prabhupada want to prove, what do you think? If you think this way, that Maharaj, if I do Sankirtan in Satya Yuga, I cannot come out successful. Not that. Sankirtan is overall. Prabhupada speaking, though there is different procedure of bhajan given, mode of bhajan different, still, Sankirtan is overall. In all yuga, every time, any time, Sankirtan is successful. So, in Teta Yuga, in Satya Yuga, in Dapar Yuga, if you go through Sankirtan, if you like to do Sankirtan, then more and more effective bhajan it is most and more and more effective bhajan procedure. To give you the exact sketch line of Gauriya Bhajan, I mean Saraswat Gauriya Bhajan. Gauriya Bhajan is okay, but if I use this open term, then all Sahajya can prove we are also Gauriya. So they are not adopting this procedure, Rupanika Bhajan Sankirtan. So I am bound to speak Saraswat Gauri. Though this word is perfect, if I can speak up to this point, those, you know, Gauriya, this is just give the exact sketch line of Gauriya Bhajan. But I am bound to speak this way because some Sahajya can speak this way. We are also Gauriya. So I am bound to speak that Rupan, even Saraswat Gauri, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. They can actually get the actual sketch line of bhajan. If they break their rule, I am 100% sure that they are not going to come out successful in their bhajan, if they like to break this procedure. Now, yesterday I told you that I like to give some example from Vedanta. From Vedanta, I like to give some example. Because Kali Kale Nam Rupe Krishna Avatar. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. In Kali Yuga, Krishna appear in the form of Harinam. Transcendental Harinam, Aprakita Harinam. Kali Kale Nam Rupe Krishna Avatar. Now, how I can understand? You will have to give example from Vedanta. In Vedanta, fifth sloka, first, second, third, fourth part there, I would like to give some example from Vedanta and like to prove what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction all the same. I like to prove this point. That's why. So, in Bhagavatam also you can find anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti sabdhyat. Why? Bhagavad, in Bhagavad, 18,000 slok there. 18,000. 18,000 slok. But the last slok, the last slok. 18,000 slok there you can find in Bhagavatam. But the last slok, 12th canto, last slok, anabriti sabdhyat aina naam sankirtanam yasyo sarva papa pranasanam pranamo duksha shamanam tang namami harim param. Bhagavat last slok. That same slok is there in Vedanta last slok. Fourth part, first part, second part, third part, and fourth part, last sloka is anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti sabdhyat. What does it mean? The open instruction given there, if you take shelter of aprakita sabda brahma, anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti man, your cyclic movement, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi matri jathare sayanam. That? Shankaracharya speaking. Your life going and going, cyclic order, death and birth, death and birth. You like to stop it? Stop it. Enough of it. If you like to speak this way, then anabriti sabdhyat mean, if you can take shelter of aprakita sabda brahma, then you are going to stop this birth and death cyclic order. You can easily get it, stop it. Stopped. Eh? Automatically again. Stopped. Cyclic order. Now your shape and design is permanent, not permanent, temporary. Your shape and design, his shape and design, her shape and design, all temporary. Even in Vedanta you can find every fraction of second you are changing your body structure, but you cannot Prakita Pralaya, Nitya Pralaya, Nitya Naimittika Pralaya, different kind of Pralaya. Every fraction of second there is changing going on. Your body structure is distorted, going distorted, but you cannot feel. And someday you can demise, you can die. It's just not permanent structure. This structure design, your design and structure, everything, anything, your design and structure, all temporary. But what about the transcendental world? There is nothing temporary or permanent. That I want to prove. Anabriti sabdhyat, anabriti sabdhyat. Anabriti sabdhyat means you are going to stop your cyclic order of death and birth. If you can take shelter of Harinam Sankirtan, how you speak this way? Anabriti sabdhyat speaking. Sabdhat means anything we can use. Sabdo, sabdo means sound? No. Same thing, Sukhdev Goswami giving answer to Parikshit Maharaj. What? That you see, if you like to be fearless, then you have to take shelter of these Naam Sankirtan. If you want to become fearless, then you will have to take shelter of these Harinam Sankirtan to rescue you, to rescue yourself from this material world. That's why Sukhdev Goswami is speaking this way. Now point is that anabriti sabdat, you understand.
Atho prechami shansiddhim yoginam param gurum purushase hayat karyam mriyamanasya sarvatha.
If you want to, Sukhdev Parikshit Maharaj putting question, hey Gurudev, what is the procedure of actual bhajan mode so that I can, come out successful, perfect. I can come out successful, perfect. How? Atho prichyami sang siddhim, not siddhim. Uposarga. Sang siddhi means siddhi. If you, in a Sanskrit Vyakaran, if you add some prefix, then the value and the power of this word enhanced. You can get it enhanced. Go up. Sankirtan. That's why sang siddhim. Siddhi is siddhi. Siddhi means all common word. 18 different kind of siddhi you can mean. But here it is written, sangsiddhi. Sangsiddhi means that kind of different siddhi is prohibited. Sangsiddhi means only sankirtan. Through sankirtan you can get. That's why you see, in Vedanta you can find anabriti sabdhat, anabriti sabdhat. Now, in Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya Charitamrita, everywhere we can get same Siddhanta. Kali Rupe, Naam Rupe Krishna, Kali Kale, Naam Rupe Krishna Avatar. Now, how we can understand that Sabda Brahma have some permanent, shape and design? Sabda Brahma, Harinam Sankirtan is equal to Radha Krishna. How I can understand? You will have to prove it through Vedanta Sutta. Can you prove? Can you prove? Yes. Now, first question is that there is material sound going on, different way. Everywhere you can get material sound. Even in the name of Harikatha Kirtan, everywhere material sound going on. By chance, rare you can get transcendental sound. In the name of Harikatha and Harikirtan, almost everywhere you have the chance to hear material sound. Not transcendental sound. Very rare. It is Prabhupada speaking this way. It is very rare. By lucky you are. By chance, you have the chance to hear this transcendental sound vibration. A practice of the Brahma, Anushilam, practice. You cannot do. It's rare. Now, my question is there, material sound everywhere going on. Is there any shape and design of material sound? Is there any shape and design of material sound? I'd like to hear from you. Answer. Is there any material shape and design of material sound? No? Yes or no? Is there any shape and design of material sound? Yes or no? Yes? You have to prove. Then you prove. Can you prove? Yes. Material sound also have some shape and design. Otherwise, how it is possible you are recording the sound again, it is a playing going on. Even cardiac, you know, if you go for, you know, heartbeat, if you like to cardiac test, you can give a zigzag, graph. That is the heartbeat of your, you know, transcription. It is a graph of your heartbeat. So, material sound also have some shape and design. If not, how it is possible? Previously, 20, 30, 40 years back, you can remember there is fiesta, meaning recorder, player, you know, big record. If you put a pin there, then a gramophone, you go on playing. That already that, you know, sound, you know, shape and design already there, grab and shot. If you put the pen and it is going on, then according to zigzag, a sound frequency come out or up and down, and it is giving the same tone as was done before. So, material sound also, I can prove, have some shape and design, 100%. Then, why you are fighting? To understand that there is a perfect shape and design, permanent shape and design of that, of Prakis of the Brahma. Why you don't believe? That's why in Vedanta Sutra, it is written, Ikshetena Sabdam. Ikshetena Sabdam. Ikshetena Sabdam mean? Ikshan mean to look, as per Sanskrit. In this Vedanta Sutta, it is prohibited for you, Ikshete no asabdam. Asabdam means which is not sabda, pure sound. Without pure sound, you should not look. Ikshete no asabdam. Asabdam means no sabdam, which is not pure sound, you should not be busy to look. That means on the in different way, if I explain. You are advised to watch that of Prakrit Sabda. If I can speak straight way, if I like to speak straight way, I would say that in the Stotra, in Vedanta Sutra, it is written that to watch material sound is prohibited. That means you are requested to watch that transcendental sound. Ikshetena asabdyam. Ikshetena asabdyam. Now, ikshetena asabdyam. That's mean aprakita sabda. You should follow, you should do bhajan, and you should get the power, gradual bhajan power, to watch that aprakita sabda brahma. Ikshetena asabdyam. So material sound you should not follow. Material sound. Because material sound is dangerous for you. It can kill like a deer in desert. Any hunter, he is playing on flute. Nice. And that harin, the deer coming. Oh, so nice, sweet sound coming. After that he is coming in range. Shoot. Then arrow. Then this way you are always dancing in hotel there in buffet system feast. We say buffalo system, not buffet system. They are speaking the educated society, civilized society. They are uncivilized. Swami Maharaj used to say they are actually buffalo. So not buffet system. Buffalo system. Uchista. Everybody taking uchista of each other. You know. So this way, you see, so everywhere, you know, material sound can put you in trouble. Material roop, beauty, material beauty can put you in trouble. From Bhagavad, I can give example. For Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving example to Uddhava. Uddhava, how this common people, material people, they are in danger. Shabda, sparsha, rup, ras, gandha, sound, beauty, you know, sparsha, touching, you know, enjoyment. This kind of sabda, sparsha, rup, ras, gandha, smell. This way, all five factors, elements, how those jivatma putting themselves in trouble. So, ikshetena asabdhyam. Another sutra I should quote from Vedanta. One sutra is there, fifth sutra is there, ikshetena asabdhyam. And another sutra is there, which is called Gaunaschet na atmo sabdhyam. Gaunaschet na atmo sabdhyam. Atmo sabdhyo is not inferior sabdha. Atmo sabdhyo is always have some gravity. Gaunaschet na atmo sabdhyam. Try to remember. Gaunaschet na atmasabdham. Atmasabdhya. Atmasabdha mean? What do you mean by atmasabdha? What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove in front of us through Sankirtan. Atmasabdha mean? There is no difference between the sound and the object it means. Atmasabdha mean? Atmasabdha mean? Atmasabdha mean the sound and the object it means. Is non-different. Atmasabdha means the sound and the object it want to means are the same. That is the Atmasabdha. So in Vedanta Sutra, Vedavyas Goswami want to prove the Gaunaschetna Atmasabdham. Atmasabdha is never inferior sabdha. Atmasabdha is has some gravity, guru, heavy. Heavy means? Has some transcendental feature, a prakito, roop, gun, everything there. All transcendental qualities you can find, you can see. Gaunaschet na atmasabdham. Atmasabdha is not inferior sabdha, it has some gravity, very heavy. That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak this thing. Saddha sadhan satya jekishi shagal. Nam Sankirtana Paive Sakal. Saddha Sadanta, what you want to get through Saddha Sadantatta? Saddha Sadantatta, you want to get something, what is your goal? The same thing you are going to get through Nam Sankirtan. That's why in Bhajan Rahasya you can get, Bhakti Mahatma giving example, Mahaprabhu speaking in front of Raya Mahasaya. Here I, Nam Sankirtanam Kalu Upai. Nam Sankirtan Kalu Upai. The only procedure. But you are not following this instruction. I'm very sorry. Every time I want to give you instruction, I mean this procedure, followed it by Guru Bhargo, you must do Sankirtan. Don't go for solitary bhajan. Try to execute your duty. Go to market for buying fruits and everything for Krishna. Do archan, clean utensil, clean temple. This is temple. Where Sankirtan going on is temple, more than temple, I would say. So every time it is your duty to do this seva, to serve deities. If you have your wife, then also it is your duty to serve her, because you know, she is Guru in your darshan. You must serve. This way, Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj is showing us this procedure. If you have some enjoying mood, then or you have some hatred, both is prohibited. If you are feeling some hatred, sense of bitterness, then some sort of weakness is already there inside. Why you are feeling hatred? Why you are feeling a sense of, you know, bitterness coming? That means 100% some weakness is there inside your heart. Some brahmachari is fighting. Hey, Mataji, go! They are speaking this way. Are you what Mataji done from? Ah, his Mataji is coming here. It is your duty to control yourself. Mataji is also a devotee. She can come. If you want to rectify the whole world, you are idiot number one. Try to rectify yourself. It is the instruction by Prabhupada. If you want to rectify the whole world, hey, you are doing wrong. Yeah, you are doing wrong. You are doing wrong. You are doing wrong. You are doing wrong. You are doing right. So Prabhupada speaking, it is my request to you all to find fault with you. Don't try to find fault with others. It is the duty of Guru Varga to point out, hey, what you are doing. It is the duty of Guru Varga. Why? It is a duty for what you have accepted Gurudev. Why? To show you the exact procedure. That's why Tulsidas ji is speaking this way. Sadguru mile bhed batave, gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila chute jab aankh kare pravesh. Tulsidas ji speaking. He is also Guru. Sadguru mile bhed batave, gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila chute jab aankh kare pravesh. Now this very nice example. Sadguru mele, when you are going to get Sadguru, that is also not so easy. Because Tulsidas is speaking, Guru vina bhavanidhi tarai na koi. Binu guru bhavanidhi tarai na koi, Rama kipa vina sulava na sui. Without any strong sukriti, you are not going to get this chance to meet a Sadguru. That very thing I told you in from Bhagavatam. Very rare, it is very rare. Very rare. It is very rare. So you see, Sadguru mile ved batame, gyan kare upadesh. When you meet a Sadguru, it is the duty of Sadguru to give you special instruction about this is material, this is transcendental. This is going to put you in trouble, this is going to help you in bhajan. This way all the time demarcation is there. This is good, this is bad. But ordinary people should not speak that way. That's why Prabhupada is speaking, why you are taking trouble to find fault with others? It is my duty, I am acting as acharya. I have my duty. I can do. Let me do my own duty. Why you are doing my duty? You are doing. Sadguru mile ved batame, gyan kare upadesh. Gurudev, what transcendental knowledge? Gurudev going to give you transcendental knowledge through which you can grow relationship with Krishna, and you can cut relationship with Maya. This way, Gurudev can give proper knowledge, perfect, Dibya Gyan. Dibya Gyan? Sadguru mile ved batave. When giving advice, gyan kare upadesh, then kaila ka maila chute. Coal tar and core you see is black in nature. Black? Coal is charcoal or coal, always black. If you touch, you will have to wash your hand. But when you fire is there, then gradually you find that is growing, you know, like gold, molten gold. Huh? There is no blackness. You can find blackness now when it's growing. No blackness there. Blackness vanishes. So when Gurudev give you knowledge, giving you power to do bhajan, when you are doing bhajan, then you are like molten gold, fire. Sadguru mile ved batame gyan kare upadesh Kailaka Maila Chute. Chute means you cannot get now the blackness of that coal. Now it is, you know, like gold, you know, molten gold. It's so nice in color. That is the power there with Sadhuguru Vaishnav. So strong Sadhuguru, like fire. They can bless you and take you up to that level, provided your saranagati, submission is 100% sub, perfect. Two factors there. One is Gurudev is not Sadguru, that's why you are not getting power. One point, it can so happen that Gurudev is not Sadguru, that's why you are not getting power. Second point, it can be so that you are not 100% sincere and inclined. Gurudev is Sadguru, but still you are not getting. Like, you know, Ramchandrapuri. Madhavendrapuri was Gurudev. But still Ramchandrapuri Pad not getting any facility. He is losing bhajan. He is finding fault with Guru Varga, not only Guru Varga, with Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. Hey, you are doing wrong. You are so greedy. You have taken sweet inside room, so there is ant I find moving around. You are actually foolish. Mahaprabhu silent, not speaking anything. This is a Guru Varga. Really Guru Varga? No, he is not Guru Varga. He is not. But Mahaprabhu want to set the example, Tinadopi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to bear all kind of torture, everything. You know. But when you are going to break Siddhanta, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can catch you. What? You see? What are you speaking? Ballavacharya? When I cannot accept the Siddhanta of, you know, Siddha Saipa. So I make new commentary. You cannot accept Siddha Saipa? Siddha Sami is the, you know, topmost, you know. He is writing commentary of Bhagavatam by the blessing of Nishingadev. Mahaprabhu speaking this way. Shami nahi mane tare besha madde guni. He is pros who is not going to honor his own husband. He is pros, actually. Shami nahi mane tare besha madde guni. So heavy, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But when somebody is going to insult Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu is silent because he is insulting me. Same thing with us. If you insult me speaking all Ravi second, I am not angry. But when you stop me speaking Harikatha, breaking Siddhanta, I can, like dog, I can bite you. Because I am dog of my Guru Varga. You know, I have pet dog, I am my Guru Varga. So how I can let you go free? I can go. I can go behind you. This is the system. Is Rupanugo, Saraswat Gauriya Vaishnav can feel this way. Now, actually point is that this Siddhanta, you can understand this. See, this Siddhanta. What Siddhanta I told you? Gaunoschet na Atma Sabdam. That means Atma Sabda, transcendental sound, is just the same. The sound and the object, it means all the same. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to speak. Same thing. Through Sankirtan you can get the pastime of Radha, Govindo, Dham, Nam, everything you can see all around you. If you go on doing Harinam, you can see everything in front of you. Everything. So you'll have to take shelter of Sankirtan Yajna, you see? And Tan Nishto Mokhopadeshat. Tannishthasya mukhyopadeshat. Another Vedanta Sutra. Who can get moksha? I mean, get free from this material world, maya, clutcher of maya. How you can get free of this maya, bondage of maya? Maya, how? Tannishthasya mukhyopadeshat. That means, moksha means material in this world, different bhajan mode is there, being followed by yogi, gyani. They can explain this word different way. Moksha means to go out of this material world and to submerge with Brahma. But we don't believe. Because actually, as per Gauriya Siddhanta, moksha, I mean, they think moksha means this material maya cannot put us in trouble anymore. But what it concerned to us? What is the speciality with that? Okay. Material bondage, material, you know, situation not going to put you in trouble. But what thing, what special thing you want to get? Any special thing? Because Prabhupada speaking, suppose you are free from maya, suppose. For the time being, if I say, well, you are out of maya, then what is the speciality you are going to get? After you are going out of maya, what is the duty? What is your duty? Prabhupada speaking. No acharya can speak this way. Man, come on, point out. Okay, you are out of maya, but what you want to get after going? Prabhupada speaking, those who are going out of maya, they are bound to fall down again in maya. Or they can become mayavadi if they are not going to take shelter of Sankirtan. This perfect, 100% perfect Siddhanta, you cannot hear anywhere. 100% perfect. Suppose you are out of maya, but still, what you want? After you are okay, you are out of maya. But still there is possibility, 100% possibility. You can fall down. Or you can become mayavadi. Because you are not chanting the glories of Krishna, you are not doing Harinam Sankirtan. So that's why Prabhupada is speaking, after conquering maya, what is your duty that you will have to discover first? Follow? So anyhow. So moksha mean mukti. Moksha mean mukti. But if at first Gaudiya Siddhanta, what do you mean by mukti? As per Gaudiya Siddhanta, what do you mean by mukti? What is written? Siddhanta? Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti te mukti. Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti te mukti. That is the definition of mukti as per Gaudiya Siddhanta. Muktir hitva annatha rupam. By mukti, if you like to submerge with impersonal effulgence, is actually you are number one foolish. Mukti hitva anatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti te mukti. Sarup mean, in Chaitanya Charitamrita you can find this word, jiver sarup hai Krishna nitya das. You hear this point? Jiver sarup hai Krishna nitya das. It is the sarup of all jiva, that they are the servant of Krishna. You will have to discover this point first. Jiven sarup hai Krishna nitya das. Yeah, we all jivatma are the eternal servant of Krishna. We are not the servant or maid servant of Mayadevi. Be careful. We are all the eternal servant of Krishna. Krishna bhuli shai jiv anadi bohir mug ataye maya tari day shangshara diru. You forget Krishna and you are attracted by maya, that's why you are falling into this material ocean. You are getting, unnecessarily you are getting pain. Unnecessarily you are getting pain in this material world. Huh? Amrita, srinantu amrita saputraha. In Veda it is written, hey Amritasya Putra, you are the son and daughter, I mean, Putra Amritasya Putraha. Eh? Mean, you are all the son of that Nectarian Purush. Don't forget that. Nectar is there inside your heart. You cannot discover. That is, it is my duty to uncover. Covering. And show you the nectar is already there inside your heart. That is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. That is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. Why? It is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. satsanga prapate pungheer bahuvir sukriti purva sanchitai. If sukriti is there accumulated, bhaktimukha sukriti, then gradually, if bhaktimukha sukriti is there, accumulated so much bhaktimukha sukriti, then today or tomorrow you are going to get this facility to meet with a pure Vaishnava who can guide you perfectly. Who can guide you perfectly. Now actually, point is that what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give us, anarpita charing chirad karunavatarana kalu, is it? Chirad adattam nijavitta guptam sa namamrita sa nam prema sa prema namamritam ati udaraha apamaram je vitatara gauraha krishna yanebhyo so smiham prapadye chirad adatyam nijavitta guptam sa prema namamritam ati udaraha Chirad adatyam nijabitta guptam. There is the own soul property of Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya. Chirad adatyam nijabitta guptam sa prema namamritam ati udaraha apamaram je vitatara gauraha Krishna, Krishna yanebhyo swasmiya ham prapadye. Very secret slok. If I go on discussing, you can go mad. So nice nectarian slok. But no time. Life is very limited. If we go on chanting and glorifying Krishna, whole life, billions of lives, crores of lives, still it is insufficient. So you see, there it is written so nice that what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give us this clue that whole bonded soul. This is the topmost facility waiting for you. What? You are going to relish five kind of rasa with Krishna. Param vijayata se Krishna sankirtanam. If you do Narayan Sankirtan, it is not Sankirtan, not Sankirtan. Sankirtan is only applicable for Krishna, not for Narayan. So you see, Nam Sankirtan is only possible for Krishna. You have the facility, this topmost opportunity waiting for you, that you can exchange that five kind of rasa with Krishna, with not with Narayan, not with Ram. You cannot enjoy this rasa fully. Narayan? How much you can go? Dasa. There is no birth, no father, nothing, no. With Ram, topmost you can up to go Sakya and after that Basala little bit. That also not fully. What kind of facility you can get if you do Narayan Bhajan, you can do Nishinga. Okay, we prayed under the Nishinga Dev. But perfect you are going to get this facility if you can exchange rasa, if you can do bhajan of Krishna, you have 100% facility waiting for you. Then you can exchange rasa. If you want to exchange dasa rasa, santa rasa, that is also topmost. Santa rasa you can get in Krishna bhajan, if you do Krishna bhajan. Topmost dasa rasa you can get through Krishna bhajan, rattak, pattak, adi, they are all. Topmost, topmost you can get, Sakya rasa through Krishna bhajan. Only is it possible there. Krishna can play with boys, these coward boys. They say, hey Krishna, you have defeated now. You will have to carry me in soldier. Well, come, I am defeated. Come. And Siddhamena parajitaha. By Siddham he is defeated. Siddham says, hey, take me on soldier. Well, I can take you, sir. And soldier with hip, you know, toe. Striking on chest. Kicking on chest, Krishna. Only possible when you are exchanging Vasala Rasa with Krishna. Not Krishna, Bhujandanandan Krishna. Nandanandan Krishna. Only if this kind of facility you can get. You can beat Krishna. Kick Krishna. You can give uchis. Hey, take how much? One, my Guru Maharaj used to say very nicely and laughing. In, you know, so long tree there. So those boys took decision, coward boys, we can, you know, stand this way, you can climb, he can climb this way, we can make a ladder, you see, and climb the tree. And nice fruit is there, mango. Then the topmost coward boys, just take, nice, hey, you take, last you take. After that, you all full of tylin, you see, take Krishna. Krishna are so nice, you see, these uchistha. All Uchista, Krishna taking. That is why Brahma got the scope to misunderstand Krishna. He is Supreme Lord, he is taking Uchista. It's coward boy actually. God, it cannot be Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord, how possible Supreme Lord can, Supreme Lord, how Supreme Lord can get in Uchista? Huh? Useless. You know, this way Krishna, only Krishna can give this facility to exchange Vatsala Rasa, Shakya Rasa. You see, Vatsala Rasa, you know, Nanda Baba Singh, Krishna, can you get my chapal, wooden chapal? Yes, I can go and take the chapal in her head. Coming, Balgopal, coming, Balgopal coming. Here is you, here you are. He's giving wooden sandal, putting on his head. Ah, Papa, Papa, I get sandal for you. You take. So nice. So this is called Vatsala Rasa. Only with Krishna you can get this facility. Not with anybody. So why you are not doing Krishna Bhajan perfectly? Eh? Why you are trying to get material rasa? Eh? Why? Eh? After that, Madhur Rasa is topmost. I told you repeatedly. In Chaitanya Charitam it is written, all rasa is excellent. All rasa is excellent. Suppose you are going to practice Vatsala Rasa or is going to practice Shaksha Rasa. All rasa is topmost for the devotee he want to follow. For him that rasa is the topmost. All rasa are topmost because they are Vaikuntha Rasa. You can make it up, down, you know, low and high. There's no such point. But one excellent point is that Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, okay, all rasa is excellent in his own nature. Yeah. But if you think about madhur rasa neutrally, if you are neutral, if you are standing on neutral point, if you like to judge which rasa is most excellent, then you can find madhur rasa is most excellent. This madhur rasa is almost rare. And in this madhur rasa also divided into two categories. One is that authentic and unauthentic according to his material version. Nothing is authentic, is everything authentic. I mean, it is written sakya and parakya rasa. About this point, someday I can discuss if you can prove your quality. If you can prove your quality, then someday I can discuss this point. But what I mean to say, in South India and in this material society and in different parts of South India, those people, they are not at all ready to accept this madhur rasa. They are saying this is not good. It is not authentic. It's very bad. Huh? It's very bad, it's not authentic. Krishna, they are serving Krishna like, you know, it's a bad way. Krishna is Supreme Lord. But for Gaudiya devotees, they are under the guidance of Radharani, they can prove this rasa is topmost. Because after madhur rasa, we cannot, you know, think. All rasa is there in madhur rasa. Akasher gunjana parapara bhute. I told you some days ago, Shabdo sparsha rupa ras gandho. Huh? Khiti apo tej marud gom. Khiti apo tej marud gom. I told you. Khiti means mud, earth, apo, water, tej fire, fire, apo tej marud. Bayu, boom, space. Kiti apotej morubhav, one is related with other. If you analytically approach, you can find one tat, if you find one kiti, apa, tej marud bom. From bom, gradually you can find all tatta, second tatta, first tatta is already there, third tatta, first and second already there, third, fourth tatta, first, second, third already there. This way, madhurasa is excellent. Why? Because all rasa you can find exclusively. All rasa is there inside this madhurasa. Follow? What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, this thing, through Sankirtan, if you go on doing Sankirtan, you can get actual mukti. Mukti means you can get seva. Sarupena vyavasthiti. Sarup means jive sarupa Krishna nitto das. Das, what is the duty of das? Servant, to serve Krishna. That means mukti means we go here, we should think this way, that it is our duty to serve Krishna wholeheartedly. From heart, we are going to serve Krishna all the time. So, what Prabhupada wanted to speak, who is devotee? Who he want to render service whole day and night, want to do something about Krishna. I mean, name, you know, sarup, name, everything. Krishna, Krishna sarup, Krishna naam, you know, Krishna parikar, vaishishta. Always and every time, if your mind is always engaged, always and every time, without any gapping, incessantly engaged in seva, then you are Siddha Mahatma. Follow? Then you are Siddha, otherwise you are not Siddha. This thing in front of all public, thousands of public in audience, I speak this way. If you are Acharya, big Acharya, if you are not totally established in Advaita and Tatya, then somehow more or less, you are attached with material tattva. You are doing asasanga. Be careful. Maybe apparently you are big acharya. Basic material conception is always there. Somehow, some material contamination, then you are not perfect acharya. Those who are not totally established in Advaigantattva. Advaigantattva means wherever you see, you can see Krishna inside everybody. Don't try to see any shape and design of anybody. Don't think that way. In that case, you are totally established in Advaigantattva. If you are not established in Advaigantattva, then more or less you are contaminated, your heart is contaminated with matter. And same thing I told you repeatedly. What I told? Vishashakta chityanam Krishna vesho sudurataha. If your heart is contaminated with matter, then you are not perfect sadhu. But still, you are sadhu, according to your own level. Not that everybody can attain that kind of, you know, stage. Not that. Gradually, they can go up. This way, you see, today, it was my duty to prove this factor that Nama Sankirtanam is the slogan of Gauriya Math, Sarasvat Gauriya Sampradaya. It is all. Well, I wanted to prove this way, actually. So, this way I can prove, actually, Prabhupada wanted to speak this way, that we Sarasvat Gauriya Sampradaya, we must do Sankirtan all the time, because through Sankirtan, we can satisfy Sankirtan Pita. Sankirtan Pita, if you like to satisfy Sankirtan Pita, Krishna Chaitanya, that is the only procedure. For the sense gratification of all the sense organ of Krishna Chaitanya, you must do Sankirtan. Why? Through Sankirtan, everything is possible. Why? Because Naam, transcendental Harinam is so excellent, you have no power to realize it. all your sense organ can be engaged in Harinam Sankirtan. How possible? All your sense organ can be engaged in Harinam Sankirtan. They cannot get even a single scope to go outside. Follow? Tunde tandobinirati vitanite tundavalilabdhaye karna kro karammini ghatayate karna ar vridhya spriham cheto prangana sangini vijayate sarvandhyanam kriti no yani yanita kiyat amriti krishneti varnaddai. Tunde tandobinirati vitanuti vitanute tundavalilabdhaye. Who speaking? Rupa Goswami was speaking. Tunde tandamini ruthing vitanate tundavali labdhai karna kroro karammin ghatayate akarnar vidibhyas priham cheto prangana sangini vidayat vijayate sarvindriyanam kritim no jani janita kyat vid amriti krishneti varnaddai radharani crying. Oh, Sokhi, what to do? My ear, you know, going to sound. My eye want to see Krishna. My lip, I mean my tongue want to sing the glories of Krishna. This way all my sense organ, you know, distorted. Tunde tandumini ruti vitanuti. Tundavali labdhai karna kroro karam mini ghatayate karanar vidibhyas priyam. I need to get crores of ear, crores of eyes to see Krishna. Can you feel this thing? In what level you have to go? You are acting like Sahajya. You are not following Prabhupada. I am very sorry. If you have the chance to hear all this top secret, then you will have to regulate your life this way. Otherwise, you cannot give. If you play with me, I am also a big player. I told you, sportsman. I can play with you. So you will have to do it. Now, actually, what I started with? Tadeva ramyam ruchiram nabam nabam tadeva sasyadamanaso mahasavam tadeva sokarnavasosanam ninam yaduttamusloka yaso anugiyate. If you are going to anugiyate, anugiyate means under the guidance of Guru Vaishnav Saraswat Gauri and Rupanuga Guru Varga, if you are going to chant Harinam Sankirtan, tadeva ramyam ruchiram nabam nabam, it can give you new rasa every time, like volcanic eruption. All siddhanta can come, all rasa can flourish inside your heart. This way, tadeva ramyam ruchiram nabam nabam, tadeva sasyad manuso manusoma. It is the big feast of my mind. What your mind like to get? Sweet ball or paramanna? Your mind? It is a big feast. It is a big feast for your mind. You see? Tadeva ramam ruchiram ravam tadeva sasyad manaso mahasa. Tadeva sokarnava sosanam niva. What is a grief? You have grief inside your pain inside you? All vanish. Because this is the only solution if you do Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Vancha Kalpadarvasya ki Vasindh Vyavajya, Patitanang Pavana Bhavishna Bhyo Namona. If you have any question, you can put. No question? Dhanuvad.
I have a question.
What question?
Swarupai Krishna Nityadas. According to Shastra Praman, Guru Shastra and Sadhu, what is the conclusion? Is the Swarup of the Jiva fixed or can by association can it change?
Actually, Swarup is Nitya. It is distorted now. Swarup, regarding Rasa, I can give you this clue. According to your association, you can change your Rasa. But actually, Jiva's Sarup is Nitya Das. Bhakti Vigyan Bhartima also used to same thing. It is fixed. Dasa is, you know, everything. Fixed. It is a all higher rasa, you can get everything. So, minimum, Dasa rasa is also there. Fixed. But it is distorted due to Maya. Krishna Bhuli Saijib Anadi Bahirmukh Atev Tare Maya Tare Dei Sansaradi Du. Rasatata you can change according to Guru, what kind of association. But actually, you can, from Sadguru, you can get this clue. If you can go out of Maya, that it is my Saru, at least. So, any question? No. And now, actually, it is your duty to do all seva. Cleaning temple, cleaning bathroom. I am also cleaning bathroom. In Mar, I also used to do. Those people going to bathroom, I am cleaning bathroom. It is your duty to feel this humble bhav, to get this humble bhav. You have to clean bathroom. And you have to clean. You have to plant trees, tulsi. Yes, not laughing. You have to serve all those deities, irrespective of male and female. It is your duty to go to market, discharge all duty through Sankirtan. You can go on. Marketing, you are going Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, you can do. Cooking, it is your duty. Because Gaurakrishna Bhavaji is giving instruction, it is your duty to cook and offer to Krishna and give this plate to your wife, and after Uchishti you will have to take. So you are, this is, why you are laughing? Gaurakrishna Bhavaji was speaking this way. So you have to enjoy your life, you are getting this kind of facility. You must enjoy, dance. You are actually lucky, this kind of facility you are getting. You are actually foolish. You cannot understand. Yes. And you can, if you can follow this thing, at least 14 years, like Ramchandra. If you have to, I like to send you into bhajan field, 14 years, lifelong, but 14 years I like to test you. Continuously after 14 years, if you can prove, then you can go for further further step. In Grihastha life, if you are in Grihastha life, if you are in Brahmachari life, if you are in Sannyas life, go on practicing. 14 years continuously, go on doing. And try to prove that I am established. Then we can, otherwise I am not going to hear any kind of argument. I know your heart position. Okay, now take. Maharaj. How to develop Saranagati? Actually, it's a nice question actually. How to develop Saranagati? It means actually you want to become Saranagata, but you cannot do. Some weak point is there. Some weak point is there, that's why you cannot prove that you are 100% Saranagata. In that case, gradually you have to get the advice from Vaishnava Association. Only medicine. Through pure Vaishnava Association, you can go on hearing Harikatha, getting the facility to hear Harikatha, developing serving mood. You go on serving pure Vaishnava. If they don't give you facility, you try to understand what is the my heart there. What is the heart? You try to implement their heart. Follow. Suppose my Guru Maharaj is not going to allow me to massage leg. My Guru Maharaj don't allow me to cook for him. All other seva there? So many seva. Very nice point. Actually, Param Pujyavat Keshav Goswami Maharaj want to prove this thing. That those who are staying with Guru Vaishnava, they try to prove we are big Vaishnava, because we are staying with Guru Vaishnava. We are cooking for him, we are cleaning him, giving message. Not that. Keshav Goswami Maharaj and Prabhupada and me also always speaking same thing, same Siddhanta. Suppose one father has two sons. One son staying outside, long, thousands of miles away, and executing the order of father. And one son staying with father and disturbing him all the time. Disturbing. He is staying in father. Always staying in father. But another son staying thousands of miles away, he wanted to implement the desire of father, sending money, giving facility. Then, in your opinion, who is serving? Father? Those who are common people, foolish people, they can speak this way, is the son is staying with father, he is serving? No. So follow. My Guru Maharaj is gone. And you can see Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada is always away from Gurudev. But still, he is doing, executing 100% seva of Gurudev. Yes. Physically, you cannot find Gaurakishore Babaji. For Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, Prabhupada not cooking, not cleaning cloth. You find? No. But he is the topmost sevak. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj agree that he is topmost sevak. Follow? So this way, you will have to follow Guru Vaishnav. Some Guru Vaishnav don't like to take any seva from anybody. They don't like you cook, they don't like you clean, they don't like message. They don't. Now you have to follow what seva they like. Direct or indirect way, you will have to satisfy their mind. Because their mind is not material mind. They like to execute the order of Gauranga, directly or indirectly. So it is your duty to fulfill their. This way you will have to very, very clever and find out. Because some Guru Vaishnav, they like to take prasadam, cook, take prasadam, sleep, going to Bhartam very secretly. They are not doing in front of you. Prabhupada not doing it in front of everybody. Same thing, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj, I am also. I cannot take prasadam in front of you, very secretly. Nobody can see. Sometime, like you can give example, in front of all Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all deities, all devotees there, that is separate example. But Prabhupada always used to take prasadam secretly, sleep secretly, and going to bathroom secretly, because you have the scope to think materially. Prabhupada cannot give you the scope to think materially. People are going to bathroom in front of you can think, oh, Prabhupada is material like me. So Prabhupada don't allow you to. So another kind of seva is also there. You will have to think what kind of seva there. If you can do, gradually you can get the power to get the submission 100%. Not that at the time of Diksha, all devotees can develop 100% Saranagati. I told you this Siddhanta. Not that all devotees at the time of Diksha, they all can prove 100% Saranagati. Not that. Maybe 50% they. After that, they go on doing seva of Guru Vaishnava, Guru, then gradually sophisticated heart. You can develop sophisticated heart. And after that, you can have 100% Saranagati, means 100% seva mood. 100% seva means 100% Saranagati. Because 100% Saranagati means 100% seva mood. Dikha kale Krishna kare atma. Dikha kale shishya kare atma samapan. Sei kale Krishna tare kare atmosam. My word is like mathematics. A is equal to B, B is equal to C, C is equal to D. So A is equal to D. If you go on serving, you can get that kind of sophisticated heart. And that means 100% seva mood. 100% seva mood means 100% saranagati. 100% saranagati means hardness of seva mood. 100% seva mood means you are going to do pure harinam 100%. Why? Atah Krishna Namadi bhave, na bhavet grajya mindhai. Sevan mukhe hi juhaya madhu swayameva spurt ada. In Bhagavatam it is written. Automatically Harinam can come. It is my request to you all to do satsanga, pure association, all the time. Don't try to fight with me. You try to pass judgment inside your heart. You can put question, I will have to speak something, you can manipulate something. So why not you are, you know, why not you think yourself, what I mean to say? Otherwise you can manipulate, you can speak something, oh, Maharaj want to speak this way. No, it is your duty. You must be intelligent enough to understand this point. I am not going to criticize anybody, I am a neutral man. So it is my request, that continuously, constant, you cry for good association. Cry. All day and night you cry in front of Sivji Maharaj, Narad Ji, Netananda, oh, please give us good association. You must go through the Manashiksha Upadeshamrita. I can give instruction after. Because so many vast things, I cannot get time to speak so much. Manashiksha Upadeshamrita. You like, you know, Upadeshamrita by Prabhupada, Upadeshamrita by Rupa Goswami Pad. Toto you will have to follow day and night. Then you can get good association. You will have to follow Chaitanya Bhagavat. So anyway, you must do bhajan. You promise me. You will have to promise me. All of you here, you will have to promise me that you can, you will do bhajan. You will have to promise me. Anyhow, you can do bhajan. That is the bhiksha. That is my bhiksha. You are giving some pranami to me. But it is my, you know, topmost pranami, I mean, bhiksha, that you promise me that you can do bhajan. It is my request to you all. Vanchakalpatra Vasikipasana.